Some employees in Australia may actually be able to enjoy their off hours in peace and quiet, as a new law designed to protect their personal lives takes effect on Monday. The so-called Right to Disconnect law is designed to prevent them from being punished for choosing to mute unwelcome notifications from their employers after they leave work, in the hope of giving them a better work-life balance. Reactions on the street are mostly positive.
I think it's actually really important that we have laws like this. We spend so much of our time connected to our phones, connected to our emails all day, and I think that it's really hard to switch off as it is.
But some think it may be difficult for this law to catch on in competitive industries.
Well, you know, we are professionals, we're well paid, we're expected to deliver, and we feel we have to deliver 24 hours a day if you have to. So the phone's always on, the computer's always on, and we're working.
Some workers in Taiwan share that sentiment. They seem to prioritize work efficiency even outside of work hours, following unwritten rules of workplace culture.
回一个讯息的话还好啦。
对，然后或是因为有时候可能也是交接上有疏失，或是有一些业务正在处理，可能需要你的回复。那如果不会耽误太多的时间，就回复一下。下面人就会去配合，比职位比较高的人，就为了不要失去这份工作，或是这个阶级上的一个既定的，就从小到大既定的一个灌输啦，就是小时候爸妈就说。
And employers here say requests for urgent responses often come from their clients, not from them.
业主交代很紧急的事情，或是业务发生一些紧急的状况，对，那个就下班后真的是要赶快处理。
In Taiwan, there's no law that grants workers the right to disconnect after hours. But people say more offices have become less overbearing, and younger workers have started standing up against the traditional demand to always be reachable.
如果今天有一方感受到不舒服的话，那我觉得这就不是一件合理的事，所以我是希望说这件事情慢慢的是能够让老板方跟员工方能够理解对方，而不是说一定要用一个法律去强制执行说啊，我可以不听员工的，或是我可以不听老板。
The line between when it's reasonable to contact employees and when it's off-limits can be a difficult one for employers to draw. Whether in Australia or Taiwan, what may be more important is clear terms on work hour expectations. Devin Tsai and Irene for TaiwanPlus.